It's cold outside, but the Prowlers will look to heat things up and earn a series split with the Columbus River Dragons. Good evening, everybody. Will Wiggleman here with you from McMorran Place in Port Huron. Thanks so much for joining us tonight, and apologies for the technical difficulties right there, but we are all set and ready to go. It's a balmy 5 degrees in Port Huron tonight, and some of the fans have been able to brave the trip and make it to McMorran Place. Everyone else, well, you guys are all right here. Thanks so much for tuning in. We have a great game tonight for you between the Prowlers and the River Dragons as Port Huron looks to get a series split in their last game before Christmas. It's all coming up right here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
Back here at McMorran Place, Will Wiggleman with you as the Port Huron Prowlers get set for their second game against the Columbus River Dragons this weekend. The first, a 7-3 loss here at McMorran Place. Jacob Kelly led the way with a hat trick for Columbus. Jay Krupp had 3 assists and Cody Wickline 2 goals and an assist in that one as the River Dragons offense was on fire for the first 5 minutes of the first period and then again in the third to pull away and earn the victory. That kept them atop the FPHL and the Continental Division as we look at the standings. The Prowlers stay in third place. That was the only game in the FPHL yesterday. 3 games tonight. It was supposed to be 4, but the game in Binghamton between the Black Bears and the Watertown Wolves was postponed tonight. But as far as Continental Division rivals go, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Mississippi Seawolves are battling it out in Winston-Salem. The Motor City Rockers are off tonight. That was a scheduled off day for Motor City. Well, we mentioned Jacob Kelly for the Columbus River Dragons. He has torn up the Port Huron Prowlers in 5 games this season. 8 goals, including 2 hat tricks at McMorran Place. He did indeed have 2 hat tricks. It is unfortunately not listed correctly on the FPHL's website, but I can confirm, I saw with my own 2 eyes, that Jacob Kelly has scored 2 hat tricks here at McMorran Place in 2 games. Well, the Prowlers will look to contain him and the rest of the River Dragons, and there's just a change or two to the Prowlers lineup tonight. Dan Chartrand slides up to the third line with Logan Coombs no longer here. While Tucker, he'll be alongside Sam Merritt and Tucker Scantleberry. Prowlers will run with 7 defensemen tonight with Adam Hainsel back from his 1-game suspension that he served yesterday. He'll be the part of the starting defense pair along with Frank Schumacher. The Foley line starts for the Prowlers up front. No points between any of those 3 last night. Not something you could say all that often this season, but they'll look to turn up the offense and Again, Prowlers looking to earn a series split. In goal tonight will be Joe Noonan. He does have a win against the Columbus River Dragons this season. That was his first start of the year, and he made 40 saves in that victory. So the Prowlers will look for a big win tonight, with the Carolina Thunderbirds playing the Mississippi Seawolves, a chance for Carolina to pull closer to that third spot that the Prowlers currently hold in the race to not play against Columbus in the opening round of the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. Of course, that is a ways away right now, but it does look like, at least in the early going, that the Mississippi Seawolves will be the team in the Continental Division that is going to miss out on the playoffs. So currently it is a race, unless things change in that department, it is a race to avoid playing Columbus, who sits comfortably atop the Continental Division standings. Race to play them, to not play them, in the first round of the Commissioner's Cup playoffs. Well, for the Prowlers tonight, we're just about 2 minutes away from puck drop, as both teams get set to take the ice here. Again, it's a sparse crowd that has braved the cold and the snow. We got a couple of inches of snow between last night and tonight, of course, and today. Of course, lots of ice as well on the roads. It's been very windy here in Port Huron over the last day or two. But this game is on, and the Prowlers and the River Dragons will battle it out in front of a smaller than usual crowd here at McMoran Place. But thank you to all of you hunkered down and tuning in here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. We hope you're enjoying the start of your holiday weekend. Christmas is coming up on Monday, but the Prowlers won't have too much of a break. They have to go straight to Elmira, where they will be Monday and Wednesday of next week. Well, as we get set for puck drop, let's take you down to ice level for the opening ceremonies here from McMoran Place.
Four, three, two, one.
get them done. And let's take a look at the starting goaltenders as we get set for tonight's game. Once again, it's Joe Noonan in the net for the Port Huron Prowlers. Over to our right, 2-0 this season with a 4.5 goals against average and a 9.09 save percentage. He had 40 saves on 42 shots in his first start of the season here at McMoran Place. That was a couple of weeks ago against these Columbus River Dragons, his first victory of the season. On the other side, Bailey McBurney, one of his two losses this year, came against the Port Huron Prowlers and Joe Noonan when he was out-dueled. A 9-2 record with a 2.84 goals against average and a 9.16 save percentage. So as they have Santa Claus to do the ceremonial puck drop here at McMoran Place. And the teams will get set to battle it out for the sixth time this season. The River Dragons have won four of the first five meetings between these two teams. Prowlers looking to get their second win against Columbus this year. It's the Storjahan line against the Foley line as we begin tonight. One of three games tonight in the FPHL. As King touches it back to Greco, all the way back down to Lane King. Taken into the wall by Adam Hainzel, back from suspension tonight. All the way out to the slot. Vartiainen pokes it out to center. Here's Devaney. Back to Vartiainen. Takes the shot, kick save, the rebound. Poked just wide. Hainzel was crashing for it. Storjahan back out the other way. Alex Storjahan pulls up, his shot blocked by Schumacher. Kelly turned around and tried to put it back on net. Here's Alexander Jemeff, number 12. To the point, Greco. First shot steered aside by Noonan. Devaney has Foley breaking, but couldn't get it to him. And the Prowlers will make their first changes of the game as we hit 1 minute into period one. Comes up to Chartrand. Now Doe, stepped in front of by Merritt. Frejo able to get it back out to center. Worked up to Jemeff. Good hit on Parsons, but nobody home in the slot or in the bottom of that circle except for Tucker Scantlebury. He feeds Dan Chartrand, tried to force it in front. That was blocked. Scantlebury went in hard to the boards as he was battling with Josh Petrantonio. Here is Petrantonio with the puck. Couldn't get it out. Parsons able to dump it back deep. 18:20 to go, first period here from Port Huron. Moved up to Liam Freeborn. 3 points last night led the Prowlers. Comes out to Freeborn. Quick shot. Turned aside by McBurney. Williams pinches in. Puts it deep out of Graham's reach, but it comes all the way around to Dalton Jay. Wickline trying to work it out. This time Oselich able to dump it all the way down, and the River Dragons have iced the puck. Well, this was supposed to be a four-game slate tonight in the FPHL, but the Binghamton Black Bears announced on their social media that their game was postponed with the Watertown Wolves. So just three games left on the docket for tonight. Frejo trying to work it out. Still with the puck. He backs up, gives to Oselich. 2.5 minutes into period one. River Dragons have iced the puck again as Schumacher wins the race to his own goal line. Once again, a light crowd here at McMoran Place with all the weather going on outside, the wind, The snow has been going on all day and all of last night. Roads are a little bit frozen as well. We appreciate everyone for tuning in, hunkered down at home, out of the cold wherever you are in the country. It seems like there's snow everywhere in the United States and Canada right now as Krupp sent one through the crease. Rogers dumped it back deep. Here's Underwood, taken off his stick by Devaney. No, Devaney looking to start a rush the other way. He sends Foley. Foley's pass cut off by Wicklide. Krupp comes in one-on-one with Alex Johnson. Johnson has to turn. Krupp, rising shot, found the back glass. Storjahan steps back in as the Dragons are onside. King a shot, saved by Noonan. Crowler's trying to clear the rebound, and they do. Merritt one-hands it up to Chartrand, has Scantlebury with him, gets it over there, but Rogers just got a piece of it. Rimmed all the way around to Chartrand, who's back to his feet after sliding into the backboards. Now Adam Vanelli to Storjahan. His pass blocked. Chartrand a quick shot. That was a rolling puck that hit the glass and didn't find its way on net. 4 minutes into period one. Not too many stoppages, just a couple of River Dragons icing so far. Shots on goal, two apiece for either side. Hope back to center. Parsons dumps it in. Greco trying to slow things down in the near side corner. Jemeff down to a knee, and he flips it high and in, and Noonan has it in the catching glove, and he'll hold on for a faceoff with 15:33 to go in the opening period. Petrantonio line and the Matt Graham line out there. Doe shot, knocked down in front. Squirts to the corner. Henning takes Doe in. Williams comes out with the puck. Here's Doe with it again. Looking all the way across. Petrantonio first on it on the near side boards. That puck chopped up over the boards into the Prowler bench. And out of play, faceoff looks like it will stay inside the Prowler's zone. Graham wins the faceoff cleanly towards Williams. Prowler start a breakout. Here's Freeborn. His pass cut off by Jemeff. Long lead pass to Petrantonio was out of his reach. Williams lost a glove and a stick as a bit of a yard sale over there from Sam Williams. And now here's Dalton Jay with a step. Jay shoots, saved by McBurney. The rebound, he scores! Dalton Jay follows up his own shot. Prowlers on the board first with 14:42 to go in the first. Well, good things happen when Santa Claus is in town. Santa Claus just came up into the broadcast booth as Dalton Jay was getting that breakaway, and I think he brought some magic with him as Dalton Jay able to finish that shot and clean up his own rebound for his FPHL leading 20th goal of the season. He becomes the first player in the league this season to hit the 20 goal mark. And he extends his point streak to 18 games. Prowlers on the board first for the first time this season against the Columbus River Dragons. They played as Justin Schmidt just launched it out of play. Devaney and Foley are saying that Schmidt went into his own end before he lifted it out of play into the stands. There's no question that didn't deflect off of anything. But we will take a timeout with 14:21 to go in period one. Prowlers up early. And maybe we won't take a break. We'll see what the referees decide to do now. They decide to drop the puck, but we will keep you right here to take a look and a couple of players on a sophomore surge. Usually, in the old adage of the sophomore slump, it's been the sophomore surge for these two guys, Evan Foley and Sam Merritt, who have had some good seasons so far. Both of them joined the Prowlers last season in December and finished the season as the... Oh, my goodness. Let me get back to this. As the PA announcer is just chirping Austin Federley right now, saying that he's out of the lineup right now because he has duties at the North Pole. Austin Federley, one of the shortest players in the FBHL. He has a hand injury. That's the real reason why he's not in the lineup, but a little bit of fun at Austin Federley's expense here from McMorran Arena. But Foley and Merritt have been fantastic this season. Of course, Evan Foley, in his first full year with the Prowlers, centering this top line with Larry Vartiainen and Joe Devaney, while Sam Merritt centering the third line as points in 12 of his last 13 games, and yesterday reached a career high with 8 goals in just his 21st game. He had 7 in 29 all of last year. Off the boards and out go the Prowlers. Here's Minnie trying to get back into the zone. He poked it in, but just touched that puck over the line as the Prowlers were still not yet touched up. And with 14:06 to go in the first period, we'll have another faceoff just outside of the River Dragons' end. There is the aforementioned Sam Merritt, flanked tonight by Tucker Scantleberry, who's been on his left wing for the past few weeks, and this time it's Dan Chartrand. It's been a bit of a rotating doors. Here's Storjahan with a sharp angle shot. Noonan able to fight it off. Chartrand, part of that revolving door of right wingers on this line since Vinny Dekumis got hurt. This time, that one is definitely a penalty. It's Adam Vanelli backhanding it over the glass and out of play. So the Prowlers will head to the power play. They were 1-for-3 last night on the man advantage. And they'll look to extend this lead. It's Adam Vanelli for delay of game. Cody Rogers had a delay of game call yesterday in the game. Here's a lead pass to Kelly, too far in front, so Noonan able to play it away. Freeborn, Johnson, Merritt, Graham, and Jay out there. As Logan Coombs on this power play unit last night instead of Matt Graham. Coombs, no, not in the lineup tonight. Graham behind the net, comes out to Johnson. Storjahan, Kelly, Greco, and LaBelle, the foursome for the River Dragons. Merritt steps out from in front of the goal line. Greco knocked Graham down. Graham back to his feet, comes all the way across towards Jay, hopped over his stick. He just tried to dump it deeper, but only found LaBelle. LaBelle's pass to Storjahan, picked off at center by Freeborn. He sends Merritt in. Merritt, a rising shot, caught the glass, comes back out to neutral ice. Schumacher fresh off the bench, back up to Sam Merritt, in with speed. Keeps it away from Greco. Evan Foley worked it up towards Freeborn. Freeborn knocked down by Greco. Doe trying to come out. Puck was out of Petrantonio's reach, but he has a 2-on-1. Petrantonio crossed to Doe, and Austin Doe couldn't get all that bouncing puck. Still loose in front of the crease. And finally, the Prowlers clear it from danger. 30 seconds left on the man advantage. Frejo just able to get it back to center as we hit 12 minutes to go in the first period. 20 seconds left on Vanelli's penalty. Ozilich finds that puck and lifts it all the way down over top of a leaping Larry Vartiainen. Here is Vartiainen, just able to keep it away from Wickline. That puck chopped out of play just as the penalty expires. 11:38 to go, first period. Prowlers up 1-0, but now they're 0-for-1 on the power play. Underwood line out there for the River Dragons. Cody Wickline on his right, 2 goals, 1 assist for him. Jay Krupp on his left, 3 helpers for him last night. And for Kirk Underwood himself, he did have a goal. As off the icing, it will come all the way back to Prowler territory. You talk a lot about that Storjahan line with Jacob Kelly, who had a hat trick yesterday, but this line was also great for the River Dragons. Of course, Jay Krupp did not play the last time these two teams had a series here at McMorran Place. He was just behind the bench as the acting head coach that weekend, as one of the linesmen took a spill. Underwood gets it back to Rogers. Hit shot, stopped by Noonan, but it trickles in. Joe Noonan got a good chunk of that shot, but it popped over him and into the net. And the River Dragons have tied it up with 11:20 to go in the first period. And it looked like a harmless enough shot. Joe Noonan seemed to get a good chunk of it, but unfortunately for him, it dropped behind him. And that is the tying goal right now. Wickline looking for more. Poked off his stick by Gino Mini. Krupp works it to Wickline. All the way out top to Rogers. Wrist shot, whistled it just wide. Krupp all the way around to Wickline behind the net. Wickline taken in by Mini. Underwood comes out with the puck. Meanwhile, Mini and Wickline getting into it. Gino Mini tackles Cody Wickline to the ice. Mini wants to get back after Wickline, and the referees won't let him. Both penalty box doors are open. It looked like Gino Mini was going to get the original penalty, but at least he was able to get enough of a fight in there to take Cody Wickline with him and hopefully for the Prowlers even things up. Both teams sending out 5, but I think I heard a call for 4-on-4. And that's exactly what we will have, 4-on-4 action. So Gino Mini able to even things up after taking the original penalty. As the Prowlers have the Merritt line out there, minus Dan Chartrand. The Storjahan line out there for Columbus, minus Lane King. And now Parsons in, takes the shot, deflected into the near side corner. Scantlebury turns away from LaBelle. Tucker Scantlebury to the front. And McBurney had the pad down, and he'll cover up. 10:22 to go, first period. In a one-all game, much better start for the Prowlers than yesterday, when they trailed 3-0 by the time we hit the first TV timeout. Devaney and Foley stepping out. Evan Foley typically the center when these two are together with Larry Vartiani, but Devaney took that face off. Unfortunately for him, he lost it. Kelly drops it off to LaBelle. Plenty of time in space. Tried to send a lead pass up to Kelly. Looks like he got a touch on it, so icing waved off. Dustin Henning up to Foley through center. Tried to get around LaBelle. Good play by Josh LaBelle to keep him from getting there. Schumacher stepped around Greco, but LaBelle took the puck. Played it right to Joe Devaney. Here's Devaney, tried to feed it in front. Just split Schumacher and Foley. Now Kelly the other way. Quick shot, held on by Joe Noonan. With 9:36 to go in period one and 48 seconds left in 4-on-4. We will take a timeout here from McMorran Place in a 1-1 game. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
Back here at McMorran Place, 1-1 our score with 9:36 to go in the first period on a cold Port Huron night. Temperature outside is 5 degrees, and the wind chill certainly a lot colder. It's the wind that's been keeping people from possibly coming to this game, although still a decent crowd for a night like this. Sparse, though, compared to what the Prowlers typically get here at McMorran Place. Thank you for everyone who's tuning in while staying warm away from all this winter weather that we're getting across the country. Had a good game so far, both teams on the scoreboard. As Adam Hainsel gives over to Frank Schumacher. Quickly, rink-wide pass to Freeborn. Steps in to the backhand. Couldn't get a shot off as Ozelinch got the stick in the way. Final seconds ticking off, so went from 4-on-4, now 5-on-5 as Johnson's shot kick save by McBurney. Pass comes all the way up towards Wickline, but it was cut off neatly at center. Here's Frageau. Underwood kicked it up to his stick and then fed it back to Vanelli. 8:28 to go, first period, is Adam Vanelli engineers a breakout. Here's Underwood. Cross corner dump. Johnson and Krupa on it. Alex Johnson rims it around this side to Scantleberry. Comes all the way to the point. Rogers in and out of the glove. Rogers brought it back in. Prowlers thought it was offsides, but it was not, as that comes out in front. Oh, what a glove save by Noonan, flashing the leather on Jay Krupp. That one looked nice for Joe Noonan. As Jay Krupp was looking for his first goal of the series. Justin Schmidt lined up as a winger right now for the River Dragons alongside Josh Petrantonio and Austin Doe. Quick shot from the point, doesn't get on net. Here's Schmidt, feeds it all the way across Petrantonio, winds and fires right into Noonan's glove. And a little bit less of emotion there from Joe Noonan. And he'll hold on. The only player that's beaten Joe Noonan so far tonight has been Cody Rogers, who picked up his fourth of the year and snapped a 7-game point drought in the process. Stands here at right point as the Prowlers look to get it out. Williams up towards Scantleberry, battled for on the boards. Chartrand able to get it to center. Petrantonio puts it right back in. Williams takes a hit from Schmidt. Merritt all the way up to Chartrand. Finds Dustin Henning jumping into the play. Henning in on the forecheck against Vanelli. Merritt took the turnover. Comes out towards Schmidt. He's able to backhand it to center with the Prowlers changing up the defense. Chartrand back in. Turned it over to King. Bartianen looking for the handle. Instead, King able to get it as far as Gino Mini at the red line. Under 7 to play, first period of a 1-1 game as Joe Devaney moves in. Rogers chopped it away from him. Now Storjahan finds King. Storjahan going to that. King with a nice move, and he just ripped it wide. Storjahan back on, and he couldn't find the yawning cage with Joe Noonan down and out. Vartiainen stops up, put it on, and deflected towards McBurney. And he'll cover up. Well, you saw Jacob Kelly score in a similar fashion. That shot that Alex Storjahan just missed, with Joe Noonan coming all the way out to challenge Lane King. Storjahan had the wide open cage, just threw it right through the crease. The Prowlers get a break. Shots right now 8-7 in favor of the River Dragons, although they didn't pick up a single shot on that rush. Try and get one here though, but Storjahan knocked down by Alex Johnson. And now the River Dragons are going to be penalized as Johnson was knocked down. Devaney wants to have a word with Storjahan, who's being escorted to the sin bin. Prowlers look like they'll head to their second power play of the night. 0-for-1 so far, and it will be the Graham unit to start it off. Two minutes up on the board for Alex Storjahan. Picked up a penalty and an assist last night. And he'll have to sit for two more as Wickline gets set to take the draw. He's out there with, against Matt Graham, he's out there with Underwood, LaBelle, and Greco on the PK for Columbus. Comes to Johnson. Over to Freeborn on the near side. Behind the net, Graham. Back to Freeborn, saved by McGurry. The rebound also stopped. Comes out to Jay, and he rang the post. Freeborn couldn't put it back on. And it's cleared by Columbus. Oh, some good opportunities there for the Prowlers. But McBurney got some help from the iron. And then Freeborn just got blocked by a River Dragon stick. Trying to put it back on net. Prowlers back in, Johnson's shot, knocked down, rebound is right there, and it squirts behind the cage. Johnson again at the point, there's a loose stick there, it belongs to Underwood. He is stickless. Graham, put it in front, Johnson a shot. Couldn't find the target. Freeborn, as Underwood has his stick back. Merritt back to Freeborn, 50 seconds left on the power play. Johnson at the point, over to Jay, takes it, and he missed it far to the side, and that's as good as a River Dragons clear. Both teams making some changes. Freeborn curling away from Austin Doe, fresh off the bench. Now Jay, still out there. His pass off a skate, and back to Prowler territory. 25 seconds left to go on the Prowlers' man advantage, and now 4.5 left in period number one. Vartiainen drops it off to Scantlebury, back to Vartiainen, poked off his stick by Ozelich. He lifts it out to center. Devaney knocks it down with the glove. Final seconds ticking off the power play as Frejot finds Doe. And Storjahan steps out of the box. Pass came in his direction, but it was behind him, so Schumacher starts to rush the other way. Vartiainen tried to put it, feed it down low, came right back to him. Frejot steps in front of him and rims it this side to King. All the way up to Kelly. Jacob Kelly looking for Storjahan, and Scantlebury got in the way of that pass. Here's King to Vanelli. Now down low towards Storjahan. Here is Alex Storjahan, steps out, looking for King. Hopped over his stick, Vanelli kept it in. 3:23 to go, first period. Here's Dustin Henning, looking for Vartiainen. Instead, Kelly kept it deep. Scantlebury couldn't chop it past Vanelli, but Vanelli shot it right off of Lane King. And it's back to Columbus territory, and the pass from King goes all the way down. Icing was going to be called, but it popped back in front towards Noonan, and he touched it, so that negated the icing. Jay took it away at center, has Freeborn with him. Jay tried to put it in front, and Rogers got down to block it. Penalty coming. It's again against Columbus. This time it's a hooking call. Prowlers to their third power play of the first period with 2:43 to go in the frame, and we will have it for you when we come back. 1-1 our score from McMoore in place. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
I've worked at Pioneer and now Corteva for 36 years. It goes by very quickly.
This is a pretty noble profession for your giving back to humanity.
Curiosity is so important. I learn something new every day.
What's that next challenge that may occur for farmers?
You do really feel like you've got an impact on what's coming.
I can see how we're making things better.
And we have the best solutions for our farmers. And I think we're here to feed and fuel the world. I'm proud to be part of that culture, and I'm proud to be part of the company.
Prowlers power play coming up as we return here to McMoran Place. Will Wiggleman with you. 2:43 to go, first period, and the Prowlers and the River Dragons knotted up at one apiece. It's a 2-minute hooking call coming against Kirk Underwood. So the Prowlers to their third man advantage of the game. They'll send the Graham unit out there. Prowlers were 0-3 yesterday on the power play. Coming into this game at 19.5%, fifth in the FPHL. While the Dragons came in still with the top PK in the league, coming in at 83.9%. As we are now set to go. Graham and Wickline again on the faceoff, as they were to start the last Prowlers power play. Comes out to Johnson, and the Prowlers set up. Johnson steps down the boards, over to Graham. Tried to find Freeborn. It was too far out of his reach, and that's as good as the River Dragons clear. Now Dalton Jay drops it to Freeborn, up to Johnson. Now it's Johnson into the zone. It was taken away and sent down by Wickline. That one off of Merritt. Puck bouncing around. Jemeth scores. Oh, the exchange between Dalton Jay and Sam Merritt just went awry. Alexander Jemeth was there to pick up the bouncing puck. Joe Noonan couldn't control it, but Jemeth could, and he gives the Dragons a 2-1 lead, a shorthanded goal for Columbus, their third shorty of the season. And for Alexander Jemeth, his first goal as a River Dragon, after 48 last year in his rookie season in Watertown, where he won a championship. It's the second shorthanded goal the Prowlers have given up this season. So they change up the entire power play unit as Devaney goes all the way across to Vartiainen. He enters the zone, couldn't get past Ozelish, and Doe puts it down. Here's Schumacher. Works it up to Foley. Rimmed around towards Scantlebury. Comes all the way up to Devaney at the point. Doe digging away. And it comes down low for Ajot. Able to put it all the way down with 30 seconds left on the Prowlers power play. Minute 10 to go. First period of a now 2-1 game. The River Dragons in front. Chopped into the Columbus bench and out of play with exactly 1 minute to go in period one. 18 seconds left until Underwood is released. So Prowlers send out the Graham line with Hainsel and Parsons. No need to have a power play unit out there, as the Prowlers do run four forwards, so they're getting ready to get back to 5-on-5 with the two defensemen. Popped almost out in front. Matt Graham was crashing the post. Rimmed around towards Parsons. Puts it deep to Graham. And with a freeborn one-timer, just went wide. Hainsel comes back in and put it on. McBurney steered it to the boards. 33 seconds left in the period. Brejo all the way up towards Storjahan. Three Prowlers back. Parsons takes the puck. He moves up with speed. Brian Parsons into the Columbus zone. Now below the Columbus goal line. Tried to put it out in front. Puck popped up in the air. Jay couldn't control it, so the Dragons started to rush the other way. Storjahan to Vanelli, and he couldn't handle that puck. Went off his stick into his feet. And that's going to do it for period one here from McMorran Place. It's a 2-1 game in favor of the Columbus River Dragons. Alexander Jemeff with the difference, a shorthanded goal with 2 minutes and 1 second left in that opening frame. And that is the difference so far. Shots on goal in the period, 9 for the Prowlers, 9 for the River Dragons. And that is where we stand as the teams head to the locker room for the first intermission. Much better first period for the Prowlers, certainly, than yesterday, but they do still trail after 20 minutes of play, and they still have some work to do when they step back out onto the ice for period two. Well, get your last minute holiday gifts at the Prowlers official team store located on the west end of McMorran Arena. The store is open every home game all season long, featuring t-shirts, sweatshirts, koozies, socks, and more. Rep your team in style with gear from the Prowlers team store. First intermission underway from McMorran Place in a one-goal game. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel. a fun Christmas gift wrapping challenge here at McMorran Place is your first intermission game. That's something that I definitely need to do. I'm sure many of you at home still have some gifts left to wrap. I know I do. But before we get into that first period, let's take a look at the around the FPHL, where there are two other games going on tonight, as the game in Binghamton has been postponed between the Black Bears and the Wolves. We also have a game that was postponed in Danbury, but it was only pushed a half an hour. Supposed to start at 7:30, which was about 20 minutes ago, but the Danbury Hattricks announced that their game with the Delaware Thunder will now begin at 8 p.m., so coming up in about 10 to 15 minutes will be puck drop in Danbury. The top team in the Empire Division against the bottom team as they host the Delaware Thunder. The only other game in action right now, the Mississippi Seawolves are in Carolina taking on the Carolina Thunderbirds, a bit of a shorthanded Seawolves team, but still no score yet, just over 5 minutes into period one. And of course here, it is a 2-1 River Dragons lead through 20 minutes of play. Well, the Prowlers got off to their best start against the River Dragons this season, was they got the opening goal of the game. Dalton Jay scored on his own rebound off of a breakaway chance, and that made it 1-0 for Huron. But a few minutes later, Cody Rogers with a shot from the point that Joe Noonan got most of, but not all, and it popped over him and landed in the back of the net. And that made it a 1-1 game. And then late in the period, an exchange between Sam Merritt and Dalton Jay went off of Merritt's stick, and an unfortunate bounce for the Prowlers. The puck just kept bouncing and bouncing and bouncing. Joe Noonan even came out to try and cover it or make a play on it, but Alexander Jemeff was the only one who could, and he got it around Joe Noonan to give the River Dragons a lead on a shorthanded goal. It was Jemeff's first as a Columbus River Dragon. Once again, shots on goal in that opening period, 9 for either side. And here we sit at 2-1 in favor of the Columbus River Dragons. Well, Christmas is coming, it's on Sunday, and many of us like to spend our Christmases with our families. And sometimes we like to sit down and watch our favorite Christmas movies. I asked the Port Huron Prowlers, some of the Prowlers, what their favorite Christmas movie was.
The Santa Claus with an E. That's the point.
Jack Frost.
All around Christmas. Bye.
So loud, so that must have
been
really close
to me. Elf. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Coach Elf.
Elf? Second?
Home Alone.
Grinch.
The Santa Claus series.
Santa Claus the movie.
You gotta go all the Home Alones. Keep it simple, but they're the best.
Grinch.
Jack Frost.
The Grinch.
Yolo Bukia Noita Rumpo.
For sure.
Lots of Elf fans, lots of Grinch fans on this Prowlers roster. And then, of course, we have Larry Vartiainen with his favorite Finnish Christmas movie that I had to get him to translate for me so that I could bring it to all of you. But hope everyone is enjoying their favorite Christmas traditions this weekend. And of course, we're glad you're starting your Christmas weekend with us here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. You can have your post-Christmas feast with us as well, as the Prowlers will be in Elmira on Monday and Wednesday. So Boxing Day matchup in Elmira, that will be here as well for you on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. But first, 40 more minutes of regulation between the Port Huron Prowlers and the Columbus River Dragons. And we'll have period number two for you coming up shortly. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
It's a balmy 7 degrees outside here in Port Huron as both teams get set to take the ice for the second period of play. Luckily for us, hockey is an indoor sport. It was an interesting first period. Both teams getting their opportunities, getting some good chances, and both broke through. A 2-1 score is what we have. The River Dragons setting up with McBurney to our right. And Joe Noonan setting up for the Prowlers in the crease to our left. Prowlers in their alternate gold uniforms for tonight's game, their final game before Christmas. Although it's a very short Christmas break, as we've mentioned, for the Prowlers. So the second period of action gets set to go underway. No penalties to speak of to begin the period, so we will start 5-on-5. It will be the Devaney line against the Storjahan line. Foley and Storjahan set to go. We're underway. As LaBelle took a shot right off of a Prowler stick and out of play. So 5 seconds into the second period, we have our first stoppage. Foley couldn't feed it further. Now Kelly, second chance, able to dump it only as far as Frank Schumacher. Bartiainen into the River Dragon zone, faked the shot, now curls back. Here's Foley, taken away by Storjahan, he gets it to center. King in with Kelly, waits for some more help, Lane King into Storjahan. And that went off of Alex Storjahan's skate. Prowler still can't get it out, as Greco took a shot, blocked by Foley on the way through. Here's Storjahan in a 2-on-1, takes a shot and the save made by Noonan. A quick developing play there for Columbus. As Bartiainen gets the red line and dumps it in softly to the cross corner. Jameff with Doe. Ozelinch also coming. Doe's shot to the net, stymied by Parsons. Here's Chartrand with some skating pace. Takes the shot off the backboards. Parsons blocked it momentarily at the line. Still comes out to the neutral zone. Alex Johnson recollects in his own end. We played a minute and a half in period two. Here's Scantlebury into the zone, trying to dance around Rogers. Couldn't bring the puck with him. Puck comes back out. Johnson backhands it on net. Puck loose there, and McBurney able to gather it in and cover up. 18-10 to go, second period. Still a 2-1 score for the Columbus River Dragons. Merritt line out for the Prowlers against the Wickline line for Columbus. Rogers able to backhand it into Prowler territory. Henning chases it down, goes off the glass, and back to River Dragon ice. Merritt brought it back in. Prowlers are offsides, they have to touch up. They do. Rogers played it right off of Scantlebury. Vanelli behind his own cage. Watched by Chartrand. Gives to Rogers. Now back to Vanelli. Off of his skate, Graham played it in Chartrand's direction. He has it. Dan Chartrand around the net, the wraparound. And McBurney got his pad to the post. Scantlebury couldn't feed it in front. Schumacher came in to disrupt the clearing attempt. Now here is Frank Schumacher again at center. Turns the corner, gets into the River Dragon zone. Rogers plays it back out, goes all the way down, just left of Joe Noonan for icing. 17:09 to go, second period. Prowlers with an offensive zone draw coming. Grand line out there, Gino Mini and Frank Schumacher, the defense pair. You know, the defense pairings for the Prowlers are going to be a little bit strange today, as they're playing seven defensemen with Adam Hainzel back from his suspension tonight. That he served a one-game suspension yesterday. Jay chases down his own dump. Vanelli got there first. A couple of River Dragons took Liam Freeboard into the boards. Meanwhile, a quick shot goes wide. Kelly out to center to Wickline. A couple of Prowlers back. Cody Wickline drops it off Kelly, a one-time blast. And Noonan has that in the glove. And he'll cover up, thought about the pass, but instead, he'll get the whistle. 16:34 to go, second period. First defensive zone draw of the period for the Prowlers. They'll send out the Foley line. Matching up against this top line of the River Dragons, Storjan, Kelly, and King. King to Kelly, one-timer just whistled wide. First shot from the point comes out towards King. He couldn't put it back on, as that went off the backboards. Brian Parsons is without a stick, but he can go pick it up as Devaney enters the offensive zone. Devaney held up by LaBelle. Foley in there to help. He works it to Vartiainen. Put it just wide. Parsons trying to get it back on net. Instead comes to Vartiainen again. Larry, some nice skating moves. Tried to power to the post. Comes out in front. Save. Rebound. Another save. It still sits there. Devaney down. And Kelly moves to center. Prowlers had a couple of whacks at that loose puck as Kelly with a nice reverse hit on Brian Parsons, and then King steamrolls Alex Johnson. Devaney back on the Prowlers bench. Meanwhile, Johnson gets it to center. Chartrand knocks it down there, has Vartiainen, gives it to him. Down low, Foley just deflected it wide. Vartiainen again, winds and fires, deflected down. And finally, McBurney able to get a glove on it and slow things down. 15:15 to go, second period. Danger on both ends, but the Prowlers unable to tie the score. So Merritt gets his line out there, up against the Petrantonio line. Looks like a few repairs just have to be done to the netting there just to make sure those pegs stay in. River Dragons have Alexander Jemeff split out wide on this faceoff, but the puck comes instead to the near side. It's chopped out by Petrantonio, but he knows he iced the puck, so he won't even bother skating after it. Adam Hainzel wins the race. And we'll do the faceoff again in Columbus territory. Looks like Tucker Scantlebury having a conversation with referee Chris Rowe. Not sure what about. But either way, faceoff this time to McBurney's right. Merritt wins it back cleanly, but I think they called a false start. Petrantonio and Merritt will line back up again. Merritt wins it cleanly again on the second opportunity. Here's Frejo, though, trying to get it out. Doe's pass deflected. Merritt chopped it back forward. And now Scantlebury into the zone. Backhands it deep. Frejo stepped in front of Chartrand. And Chartrand took him in. to a side scrum. Pops out towards Petr Antonio. He played it right off of his teammate Jemeth. But now a good play up to Alexander Jemeth, who has Doe with him. Jemeth shoots, and Henning got a stick on it. And that puck flies into the suites behind the net, out of play. 14:26 to go, second period. No goals yet in this middle frame. So it's still 2-1 Columbus. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
I'm proud to serve farmers because everything they do matters.
If I could choose one word to describe a farmer, I would say essential.
Dedicated.
Enterprising.
The most creative people. They're providing food for the rest of the world.
Some of the qualities I look for when hiring is personality, perseverance, someone that's determined. We want to be able to hire someone that understands what we're supporting, and ultimately that's the grower.
Back here at McMoran Place, 14:26 to go, second period, and the Prowlers trailing the Columbus River Dragons by a score of 2-1. Faceoff coming in Prowler territory. It's Brickline and Matt Graham set to take the draw. Prowlers have three lined up on the inside, and Frank Schumacher up against the boards as we are just awaiting the signal that we're all set to go. Nobody lined up directly behind Matt Graham. As now we are all set for the faceoff. Graham wins it to Schumacher on the boards. Was taken by Krupp. Here's Underwood with a shot. Fired it wide. Rogers put it back on. That goes wide the other way. Vanelli put it back towards Prowler's territory. Minnie up to Jay. Tried to one-touch it across. Instead it comes back. Krupp has Wickline going to the net, but he takes the shot himself. And Noonan makes the save. Schumacher turned it over. Here's Krupp again. This time he'll pass it off. But Wickline was knocked down by Schumacher. Prowlers come out. Jay looking to split the defense. Knocked off his stick. McBurney still to make a save. Freeborn couldn't corral that loose puck. Now Krupp again into Port Huron territory. His shot, sharp angle shot handled by Noonan. Rogers back to Krupp. Now quick shot by Storjahan. Rises over top of the crossbar. Storjahan over to Rogers. Prowlers get it out. Jay trying to drop it to Graham. He's just able to chop it in. Storjahan back to the Prowlers zone. Here's King pulling up to the point. Greco deflected wide. Storjahan first on the loose puck. Under 13 minutes to play in this second period. Devaney trying to outrace LaBelle for that puck. Now Devaney almost picked off a pass. Foley did intercept that one, but Storjahan able to recover for Columbus. Devaney knocks it down with his glove at center. And now Greco behind his own net. Shots on goal, 13 apiece for either side with 12 and a half to go in period two. Storjahan in Kelly's direction, but it was poked away by Johnson. Greco had it go between his legs. Martianen trying to put the pressure on. It comes all the way back to the Prowler zone. Alex Johnson up to Martianen, and he'll dump it in. LaBelle reverses to Greco. Only got it as far as Foley, who knocked it down with his hand at the line, but his shot was blocked, and it comes out to center again. Neither team really able to get a good look on net in the past couple of minutes. And the good looks they have gotten have gone wide. There's Parsons with a shot. I think that one may have gotten all the way through, but it didn't go through McBurney as Noonan steers away that pass. Devaney up to Scantleberry. Surrounded by River Dragons with the Prowlers changing. Now a scrum ensues on the near side board. Chartrand, Petrantonio, Scantleberry in there. Petrantonio digs it out. Drops it to Frageau. Up to Underwood. Trying to get around Williams. One hands it to Doe. Across to Petrantonio. Couldn't get it up to his stick to get a good shot off. And Scantleberry just sent it all the way down. And the Prowlers have iced the puck. 10:59 to go. Second period. And the shots on goal still sit at 13 apiece. So the faceoff in Prowler territory, won by Merritt. Worked up the near side boards towards Scantleberry. Chartrand starts a rush, gets in, shot saved by McBurney. The rebound put back there, and McBurney this time has it in the catching glove, and he will hold on. So this time the faceoff coming in the offensive zone for the Prowlers. Gramline out there against Wickline. This has been a familiar matchup tonight. And this time Wickline wins the faceoff. Vanelli around his own cage. Jay trying to force it deeper into the zone. Finally does. Vanelli has to collect behind his own net. Now got through Minnie at the point. Here's Wickline working on Schumacher. That shot along the ice goes wide. Gino Minnie up to Freeborn. And now Minnie again dances by one man and feeds Schumacher. Gets into the zone past the halfway point of the middle period. Minnie just couldn't control that bouncing puck. Good play by Gino Minnie to poke it off of Underwood's stick. Graham with some space, tried to pass it to the slot. Couple of players converging. Now Jay put it on net. That went off a body and wide. Freeborn trying to force Wickline's hand. Cody Wickline able to get it up to Kirk Underwood. River Dragons in on side. Goes off the far boards. Rogers backhands it towards Krupp. He lost the handle. Now Gino Minnie. Leading pass up to Foley. Evan Foley hooked from behind. And the whistle blows. And a penalty shot is coming for Evan Foley. Penalty shot is the signal from the referee. Evan Foley took the long headman pass, went into the zone, was taken down by, I believe, Josh LaBelle. And Evan Foley will get a chance one-on-one with Bailey McBurney. Though Foley a little bit slow back to his bench. Did go in hard on McBurney and into that post. And we'll see who takes it. Evan Foley is still bent over, getting some attention from the trainer, Bridget Smith. And he's stepping onto the bench, so it doesn't look like Evan Foley will be the one who takes the penalty shot for the Prowlers. We'll see who Matt Graham sends out. I believe it will have to be somebody from the ice. Although, both teams have headed to their benches, so I'm not sure the five that were on the ice for the Prowlers. The only Prowler on the ice right now is Dalton Jay. Although now, he thought he was about to step onto the bench. He's not. We will take a quick timeout with 9:10 to go in the second period. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of...
Never mind then. I thought we were going to immediate timeout instead. We will have the penalty shot. It's Dalton Jay to take it. So Evan Foley draws it number 94 and number 92, Dalton Jay, to take the shot. He's got one in the game tonight, and he's the FPHL's leading goal scorer. Dalton Jay, with speed, hit the crossbar. He beat McBurney, but not the iron. So this stays a 2-1 game. Lots of speed from Dalton Jay, almost like a breakaway for him. And he picked his spot. That's where he likes it, up high over the glove. But instead, he caught the crossbar. And now we will head to our TV timeout. 9:10 to go, second period. And the Prowlers unable to tie the score on that penalty shot. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron.
Back here at McMoran Place, 9:10 to go, second period, and still a one-goal game in favor of the Columbus River Dragons. Will Wiggleman with you on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Hope you're all staying warm at home while tuning in to this one. Dalton Jay just hit the crossbar on a penalty shot opportunity that was drawn by Evan Foley. So the Prowlers still trail. They do have an offensive zone faceoff coming. It's the Merritt line against the Storgehan line. Chartrand took it off the draw, gave it back to Johnson, threw a sea of bodies. McBurney found it and gloved it. So we'll do it again. The near side faceoff dot. Chartrand to Johnson at the point. His shot blocked. Merritt tried to put it back on net. That one wouldn't go. Now all the way up to Kelly. He has a step on Johnson. But Alex Johnson legally, although that puck just bounced in. Alex Johnson seemed to legally fight off Jacob Kelly. But then that puck ended up bouncing in past Joe Noonan. And now the River Dragons have a 3-1 lead with 8:51 to go in the second period. And it looked like, I think Noonan got it with the poke check. And then it hit Kelly as he was on his way by and bounced back in. So the Prowlers now trail by two with 8:51 to go in the second period. A much better game for Port Huron than yesterday, but still unable to solve the Columbus goaltending, which has been a struggle for just about every team the River Dragons have played this season. Williams bounces it off the boards and out. Graham chases it down in Columbus territory, tried to feed Jay in front. That hit a skate, and now Graham. To the point, Henning put it off the back glass. Jay took Frejot into the boards. Freeborn trying to kick it up to his stick. Can't do it, it comes back to Williams, puts it on, and McBurney, the glove save, and he'll hold on. 8:10 to go, second period. And the River Dragons have extended their lead. It's now 3-1. Foley line out there for the Prowlers. He gets set to face off against Kirk Underwood. Face off tied up there for a second. For Rogers, lifts it high and out. That one went clear out of the playing rink. So it looks like Cody Rogers will head to the sin bin for delay of game for the second straight night. With 8:03 to go in the second period, and the Prowlers will have their fourth power play, of the game. This time, they'll try and make good on it. 0-3 so far. Face off one to the boards. Greco shoved off by Vartiainen, but Wickline finds it, and he clears all the way down. Under 8 to play in the second period. Here's Schumacher turning the corner. Drops it off to Larry Vartiainen. Scantlebury back at center as the Prowlers were stonewalled at the line on the first attempt to get it in. This time Schumacher able to move it in himself. Poked over to Scantlebury. Gets it back from Vartiainen and put it on, deflected by Foley, and McBurney got it with the stick. Underwood finds the puck and sends it all the way down towards Joe Noonan. Minute and 5 to go on the power play for the Prowlers. 7:05 now left in the period. As here's Josh LaBelle wasting some more time in the Prowlers' territory. Freeborn took it from him. And now Scantlebury into the zone. Takes the shot, gloved and held by McBurney. And we'll have another faceoff in River Dragons territory. 48 seconds left on the penalty to Rogers. 6:51 on the clock in this second period. As the merit unit out there for the Prowlers. Evan Foley has just left the ice for the Prowlers, limping his way down the tunnel. Prowlers already playing with 9 forwards tonight. That just puts another strain on the forward core. Graham sauces it across to Jay, put it towards the net, looking for a tip. Comes back to Johnson at the point. Graham's cross-ice feed picked off by Storjahan. He'll move the other way. Has Kelly with him. Alex Storjahan puts it off the back wall, and Noonan had to be alert to get the pad down as Jacob Kelly tried to put it back on net. Final 10 seconds ticking off on this Prowlers power play. Johnson pulls up, lost the handle, and Frageau clears. That will take care of the rest of the penalty. So back to 5-on-5. Prowlers now 0-for-4 on the man advantage tonight. Rogers, second chance opportunity, got it to Storjahan. With Liam Freeborn coming all the way back, dangerously stick handling in front of his net. Scantlebury speeds up the left wing side, 5:39 to go in the period. Put it in front, Freeborn just fanned on the shot. Petrantonio the other way, 3-on-3 rush. He drops it off to Doe with a quick shot. That hit traffic in front. Scantlebury couldn't get it out. Shemef plays it over to the near side. Vartiainen the only one there. He'll skate up ice. Devaney over towards Vartiainen. Pass was in his skates. Sam Williams acting as the third forward on this line. Here's Vartiainen with a shot. Stopped by McBurney. So I guess that evens up the defenseman for the Prowlers as Sam Williams acting as a forward, taking Evan Foley's spot on this line with Joe Devaney and Larry Vartiainen. Here is Williams. Dumps it in as the Prowlers get a change going. Poked to Parsons. He put it on, deflected, but didn't get all the way through. Brian Parsons working down the boards. Now Jay. Here you go. Put it Dalton J with it, turnaround shot, and McBurney has that one easily in the glove, and he'll hold on. 4:22 to go, second period. Only one goal in this frame. It belongs to Jacob Kelly, and that made it a 3-1 River Dragons lead. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
I've worked at Pioneer and now Corteva for 36 years. It goes by very quickly.
This is a pretty noble profession for your giving back to humanity.
Curiosity is so important. I learn something new every day.
What's that next challenge that may occur for farmers?
You do really feel like you've got an impact on what's coming.
I can see how we're making things better.
And we have the best solutions for our farmers. And I think we're here to feed and fuel the world. I'm proud to be part of that culture, and I'm proud to be part of the company.
Back here in Port Huron, 4:22 to go, second period. And the Prowlers still trail by two. Will Wiggleman here with you on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Prowlers in the midst of a very tough stretch of games, playing seven in the span of about 12 days. This is the second game and the second day of those 12. They're in Elmira Monday and Wednesday next week, and then a home and home with Motor City Friday and Saturday, and then they're back down in Baton Rouge the following Monday. So a lot of travel, and this isn't even the hard part yet, although this is the toughest team they will face over this span. The Elmira Mammoth, Motor City Rockers, and the Mississippi Seawolves lie ahead. And that will be a tough game for both teams on January 2nd, down in Baton Rouge. That will be the fourth game in four nights for the Seawolves. And I believe three different states. Jay put a quick shot on, stopped by McBurney. So it should be interesting to see how both teams play in that one, but still a long way to go until then. Still a long way to go in this game. Prowler's still in it. It's 3-1 as Freeborn got a shot off, and McBurney gloved it. Of course, it's the Elmira Mammoth next up on the schedule for the Prowlers. The third of three expansion teams that the Prowlers play this season. Mini, his shot blocked. Of course, the other two are the Motor City Rockers and the Mississippi Seawolves. Prowlers have already played both of them. Tripping penalty coming up against Port here on Dustin Henning, the one heading to the box as he got his stick in the skates of Lane King. And the River Dragons get their first power play of the game with 3:44 to go in the second period. Dragons power play coming in seventh in the FPHL at 18.3%, while the Prowlers PK is ninth at 78.8%. Graham won the faceoff, and Schumacher rims it around. LaBelle just couldn't keep it in. Jay tried to get it all the way back down, but he didn't get all of the puck. Comes back to Schumacher, and this time he'll finish the job. Here's Storjahan. Stopped at the line. LaBelle gave it right to Matt Graham. Graham into the Dragons zone. Had Dalton Jay in the slot, but didn't see him as he was electing to go back to Gino Mini and waste some more time. Here's Chartrand in over to Scantlebury. Couldn't handle that feed cleanly. Now Chartrand tried to chop it back on goal. Prowlers getting some good shorthanded opportunities here. LaBelle gloves it down. Headman feed up to King. Noonan comes all the way out of his crease to stop it. Now the Prowlers with a 2-on-2 rush. Scantlebury, the shot held on to by McBurney. And he'll get a whistle. First minute and two of this River Dragons power play has not been spent in the Prowlers zone outside of that faceoff that began it. Chartrand and Scantlebury getting some opportunities, as well as Matt Graham and Dalton Jay with some offensive zone time on the PK. This time the River Dragons looking to get set up, and they do, as Jermef gives it over to Petrantonio. Frejoa's shot off the glass, comes back out in front, Noonan down, and it's chopped to the sideboards. Fed down low to Underwood. Now up to Petrantonio. All the way across. Jermef put it right through the goal mouth. Petrantonio tried to put it on. Comes back to Jermef on the far side. Frejoa backing him up, keeps it in. 15 seconds left on the PK for the Prowlers. Here's Austin Doe, steps in, shoots. And that one sticks to Noonan, and he'll hold on. 8 seconds left on the penalty to Dustin Henning. A minute 52 up on the clock in this second period. Both teams making changes. Graham and Jay come back out. Matt Graham will draw with Wickline. One cleanly by Wickline. Rogers gave it back down to Cody Wickline. And that quick shot from Underwood held on to by Noonan as the penalty expires. So the Prowlers will be able to get Liam Freeborn to join his line mates with relative ease, with the faceoff coming in their own end. Dalton Jay split out wide. Comes up to Vannelli, his shot stopped by Noonan, the rebound, and Noonan has that. Group tried to work it in front. Johnson took it away. Now back to center, here's Storjahan. 90 seconds to go, second period. It's dumped in, Noonan rims it around. Took a funny hop off the glass. Graham able to work it to Freeborn, and now Jay. Tried to feed it back across to Liam Freeborn. That didn't work. Now Graham again. Looking for the cycle to Jay. Instead, Vannelli cut it off. Wickline in. Pulls up. Feeds it across to Krupp. He couldn't get a handle on it. Krupp looking for a penalty. It won't come. Meanwhile, here's Dalton Jay. 50 seconds left in the period. It's worked out in front. King with Kelly. Dragons now on a 4-on-2 rush. Rogers stymied by Gino Mini. Greco kept it away from Vartianen, who wanted a breakaway. 32 seconds up on the clock. King tried to play it away from Vartianen. Larry looking to keep the pressure on. Here's Devaney stepping out with the puck. Devaney hauled down. Henning put it on, blocked. 15 seconds left. Prowlers just do keep it in. Rogers just trying to eat this final 5 seconds, and Greco lifts it all the way down. Henning hustling after it, and he'll get the icing call with 1.8 on the clock. Noonan heads to the bench, so the Prowlers will go 6-on-5 for the final 1.8 seconds of this second period. They keep Joe Devaney out here and bring the entire Merritt line out. Scantlebury set up right behind Sam Merritt for the quick shot. Michael Greco, the defenseman, in there against Merritt. And Greco just sits down on top of the puck. And that's going to do it for two periods of play here from McMorran Place. The only goal in that second period belongs to Jacob Kelly. And it is a 3-1 game in favor of the Columbus River Dragons through 40 minutes. Shots on goal in that second period, 14 for the Prowlers, 12 for the Columbus River Dragons, and for the game so far, 23 for Port Huron, 21 for Columbus. And it looks like the Prowlers are having some difficulty getting off the ice. Now they finally get the door and they're able to head to the locker room for the second intermission here at McMorran Place. So a little bit of less scoring between these two teams tonight than there was last night and then there has been during the past few games during this regular season series. But the Prowlers still trail as we head to the third period of play. Well, secure your seats for the Prowlers' next home game as they take on the Motor City Rockers on Friday, December 30th with Puck Drop at McMorran Place scheduled for 7.05 p.m. Tickets are available online at phprowlers.com/tickets or by calling the box office at 810-985-6166. That's online at phprowlers.com/tickets or online at by phone at 810-985-6166. Second intermission underway here from McMorran Place. It's a 3-1 River Dragons lead. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel. minutes down here from McMoran Place. And the Prowlers trail the Columbus River Dragons by a score of 3-1. Wilt Wiggleman here with you tonight. Thanks so much for joining us on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Before we get into that second period, let's take a look around the FPHL. There should have been three other games tonight, but Binghamton and Watertown had to postpone due to inclement weather. So only two other games to tell you about. And we start in Danbury, where that game also delayed, but that one only delayed a half an hour. That began at 8 o'clock, and they just finished up the first period, and the hat trick's already out to a 3-0 lead over the Delaware Thunder. And the other game tonight is in Carolina. The Thunderbirds rolling right now over the Mississippi Seawolves 4-0 as they play in the second period. Of course, here it's a 3-1 lead for the Columbus River Dragons over the Port Huron Prowlers. Well, it was a quiet second period. Many of the chances, especially on the score sheet, most of the chances that both teams had just seemed to miss the target. Both teams need to get their sights adjusted, it seems, as both were having trouble hitting the net. We did see a penalty shot after Evan Foley was taken down on a breakaway. He ended up leaving the ice and heading back to the dressing room limping. Dalton Drake took the penalty shot, but unfortunately for the Prowlers, just hit the crossbar and was unable to tie the score. It was a 2-1 game at that point. And then later in the period, Jacob Kelly, on a breakaway of his own, was defended nicely by Alex Johnson, who knocked the puck from him. But unfortunately for the Prowlers, as Joe Noonan was trying to poke the puck away from his crease, it hit Kelly on his way by and bounced past Noonan. So a bad break, tough break for the Prowlers, and a good break for the Columbus River Dragons. And that's where we stand now at a 3-1 game. Jacob Kelly scoring his fourth goal of the weekend. Of course, he's had some great games against the Prowlers this season. I've seen two hat tricks, although the official stats don't agree with me. I can tell you for certain he has had two hat tricks here at McMoran Place so far this season. But the Prowlers will head to period three, still looking for the tie, for some goals to tie, as they have often this season against the Columbus River Dragons. Is a comeback in the cards? We shall see. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
Will Wiggleman back here at McMorran Place, now with a hat and gloves because it is absolutely frigid here in Port Huron this evening as the Prowlers trail the Columbus River Dragons 3-1. 4 goals in this game total, and 5 degrees is the temperature outside right now in Port Huron, although with the wind chill, feels like minus 17 outside tonight. But in here, it is, well, no wind chill inside, which is nice, but the Prowlers have some work to do to send their fans who brave the elements home happy. It's a 3-1 lead for Columbus, and it doesn't look too all that great as far as the statistics go. Prowlers just 2-8-2 when trailing after two periods of play. The River Dragons 13-1 when leading after two periods. However, that one for Columbus came right here at McMorran Place exactly 2 weeks ago against the Prowlers. Remember, that was the 5 power play goal game that the Prowlers turned that lead, that game on its head and ended up with a big victory. No power play to start the period tonight for Port Huron. So we'll see what they can do as they take the ice here for third period action. And we'll see if they can get themselves back into this game. They got themselves close last night in the second period, but then Columbus got some early third period goals to kind of take the wind out of the sails. Of course, that was also helped by a second period goal with 3.1 seconds to go in the frame. Sam Williams centering this Foley line, this line now with Evan Foley in the locker room. He takes the draw with Alex Storjahan. It's Williams between Vartiainen and Devaney. And he wins it back to Frank Schumacher. We're underway in the third period. Williams in the corner. To a side scrum there. Williams is knocked down. Meanwhile, Kelly got it caught up in his equipment. Now Devaney with the steal. Out to Williams. Off his stick. Sam Williams tried to put it right through the goal mouth. Comes back to Minnie, but poked away from him before he could get a shot off. Kelly trying to spring the other way. Vartiainen muscled him off and then ran into the linesman. Maybe took a shoulder up high from the linesman, and Larry heads off the ice. Whistle blows as the River Dragons have iced the puck. Just 52 seconds into period three, and the Port Huron Prowlers still looking up at the River Dragons. Parsons tried to put it on. It was blocked on the way through and lifted back out to center, but it hit the roof here at McMorran Place, so the whistle blows. Bit of a choppy start to this third period. We want to give you an update on what's going on around the FPHL. I mentioned that the Carolina Thunderbirds are leading the Mississippi Seawolves 4-0 as Johnson's shot kicked away by the pad of Bailey McBurney. Here come the River Dragons the other way. Jameff over to Doe. He had to kick it up to his stick. Frejot played it off of Johnson. Scantlebury trying to get it out to center. We'll give you that this update in just a minute because it is some decently shocking news. Jameff back into the zone. Ozelinch tried to slide it across. Comes back to Petrantonio. DDD to Frejot. Petrantonio again to Doe. Doe below the goal line, battling with Henning. Scantleberry into the Dragon zone, takes the shot, blocked by Ozlinch. We're 2 minutes into period three. And it's dumped back down to Prowler Ice. Adam Hainzel there to recover. Henning up towards Dalton J through the neutral zone. Well, he gave it up. Rogers got it out. Mini fresh off the bench. Curls away from Wickline. He's taken down. Wickline's stick was stuck up in Mini's equipment. No call. J pulls up to Freeborn just through him, or else he would have had a good opportunity. Just couldn't get the handle. Mini wrists it on net. Underwood made sure it didn't get all the way to his goaltender. And now Krupp back out to center. Krupp to Storjahan. Enters the Prowler zone, but turns the puck over. 3 minutes into period three. Neither team really too many opportunities as the River Dragons are offsides. Let's get back to that news that I was mentioning earlier. The Mississippi Seawolves are in Carolina tonight, and the Thunderbirds are up 4-0 late in the second. Mississippi is dressing 9 skaters, not 9 forwards like the Prowlers did tonight, 9 skaters, and 6 of them were on the roster when the Prowlers played the Seawolves just a week ago. Some of the new players include Jack Raleigh, the brother of Jake Raleigh, who is a Mississippi regular. Seawolves also released a number of players, which is believed to just be a temporary measure as they seem to be scrambling for players on this road trip. Again, 9 players listed in the box score for the Mississippi Seawolves tonight in Carolina. Back to this game. I would say both teams are playing at full strength with a full roster, but we haven't seen Evan Foley, and Sam Williams has taken his spot on this line as that puck goes out of play. But we started at full capacity. So the puck comes out to center. As they say, the Prowlers just sent it out themselves. Parsons chases it down in his own end. Merritt tried the one touch towards Chartrand, but Dan Chartrand was coming back. Merritt thought he was going forward. And now Johnson up to Merritt. Sam Merritt into the zone. Goes after it himself against Ozlinch. Puck pops free. Here's Jameff. Has Petrantonio with him. Tried to get it there. Parsons blocked it out. Petrantonio, sharp angle shot. Stopped by Noonan. The wraparound try. And Noonan got that one too. Johnson. Up to Scantleberry. Gives over to Chartrand. Tried to find back to Tucker Scantleberry. Instead, it was blocked. Comes all the way back to Noonan. He plays it away to Wickline and right to his captain, Dustin Henning. We approach 5 minutes gone in period number three. As the Prowlers enter the zone, J.O. shot. And McBurney makes the save, and he'll hold on. 15:03 to go, third period. Prowlers still looking for 2 more goals to at least pull into a tie. Jay Krupp and Tucker Scantleberry with some words for each other. Scantleberry heads over to the Prowlers bench on a regularly scheduled change. Henning puts it down deep to Matt Graham. Graham worked it in front. Krupp cut it off. Henning recovers in his own zone. Now Hainzel up to Graham. Prowler start the breakout. Matt Graham has it again. Steps over the Columbus blue. Graham trying to power move. He was cut off by a couple of River Dragons. Puck worked back to the point. Hainsville fanned on a shot. Jay got it deep. Graham looking for Freeborn below the goal line. He has him. All the way up top. Henning wrists it in. Puck chopped around. And now Krupp back to center. Underwood couldn't maintain control. Williams the other way with Jay. Dalton Jay catches up to the puck. Around the net, put it in front. Here's Vartiainen with a shot. That hit Underwood, and it goes out of play. 14:02 to go, third period. And we will take a timeout. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
I'm proud to serve farmers because everything they do matters.
If I could choose one word to describe a farmer, I would say essential.
Dedicated.
Enterprising.
The most creative people.
They're providing food for the rest of the world.
Some of the qualities I look for when hiring is personality. Perseverance, someone that's determined. We want to be able to hire someone that understands what we're supporting, and ultimately that's the grower.
Back here in Port Huron, Will Wiggleman with you on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Thanks for joining us tonight. 14:02 to go in the third period, and the Prowlers trailing the Columbus River Dragons 3-1. Dalton Jay is the only goal for the Prowlers tonight. His FPHL leading 20th of the season. That extended his point streak to 18. But it's the only one the Prowlers have mustered tonight. It was the opening goal of this game as well. Sam Williams, if you're just rejoining us, has taken Evan Foley's spot on the Prowlers' top line. He's getting set for the faceoff against Alex Storjan. And now we are all set and ready to go. Chopped through the crease. Greco picked it up on the other side but turned it over. Here's LaBelle up towards King. Storjan to Kelly. He had to bunt it down. All the way into Prowler territory. Minnie almost gave it away. Storjan couldn't complete the toe drag. And now Lane King sends it all the way around. Minnie kicks it up towards Devaney. Well, the boards hit the linesman, so it comes right back to him. Greco tried to rim it around, turn it over to Devaney, but he couldn't put the bouncing puck in front where Larry Vartiainen was waiting. Devaney has it again. Turnaround shot. Williams got a tip on it. Schumacher tried the wraparound. Said it comes to Kelly. King working on the forward Devaney. Sends it in front to Kelly. Nice toe drag, and he scores. Oh boy, Jacob Kelly showing off the hands again. He makes it 4-1 Columbus. Dragons trying to take advantage, and they did, of Joe Devaney, the forward, covering for Schumacher, the defenseman who went in deep in the offensive zone. Able to work it to Kelly, and what a beautiful toe drag by Jacob Kelly, a highly skilled player for these Columbus River Dragons, a great find for them. He is a team high 18th goal of the season, is second of the night. Played in Germany's fourth division last year and now tearing it up in the FPHL. There's Scantleberry. Tucker Scantleberry works out in front, takes a shot, hit the post. Parsons at the line. Knocked down by Chartrand. He put it, backhanded it just wide. Doe back in. Johnson took it from him. Goes back to center. Alex Johnson one-hands it ahead. Frejo cut it off. Paul Frejo gets it deep. Took a big hit from Johnson as he does. Jamet first on the puck. Still with it. Now it's a scrum on the near half wall. Parsons and Merritt in there for the Prowlers. They dig it out to Alex Johnson. Short trend off the boards. Just hops over Vanelli sticking out. Now Johnson again. Up to Matt Graham. Jay tried to touch it off for Freeborn, but the communication there got their wires crossed. Luckily for the Prowlers, River Dragons missed the pass, or else they had an opportunity to come in on a 3-on-0. Here's Underwood. Put it in front, and Wickline couldn't deflect that on goal. 11:14 to go, third period. It's Adam Hainsel dumps it in. That's the side of the ice the Prowlers need to be. Now trailing by three. Underwood has a man breaking. It's Krupp. He gets it to him. It goes off of Jay Krupp's stick, and Noonan out to steer it away from the River Dragons assistant coach. Freeborn into the zone with Jay. Tried a nice move around Vanelli, but couldn't take the puck with him. Instead, it's Storjahan with a nice move of his own, but Noonan makes the save on the backhand try, and he'll hold on with 10:38 to go in the third period. We can confirm to you that Evan Foley will not return to tonight's game, so the Prowlers lose their top line center. Sam Williams, again, taking his spot right now on the line with Joe Devaney and Larry Vartiainen. 'Knocked down by Kelly, but the play just offside. So we'll do it again. This time the faceoff will be outside of the Prowlers zone with 10.5 to go in the third period. Vartiainen tried to work it forward. King able to get it deep, but it rims all the way around to Devaney. Now Greco back in his own end. Storjahan wants that puck. Instead, Greco goes to LaBelle and gets it back. Michael Greco. Back to his D partner, LaBelle again. King enters the zone. LaBelle wanted the one-timer. Storjahan goes down low to Kelly between his own legs. And Noonan made the save. Storjahan tried the wrap, and Noonan got that one too. Jacob Kelly trying all sorts of fancy tricks. Here's Vartiainen back into the zone. All the way across to Henning. His shot kick save by McBurney. And Storjahan cleans up the rebound. Noonan's just going to glove that dump in, and he will hold on with 9:37 to go in the third period, and the Prowlers now down by three. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
Adventures await you at the award-winning DoubleTree by Hilton Port Huron. Experience the breathtaking view of sailboats and freighters framed against the background of the impressive Bluewater Bridge, all from the comfort of your elegant guest room balcony. Planning a wedding? The DoubleTree by Hilton has the perfect setting to celebrate a marriage with its wonderful landscaping and beautiful reception area. So whether it's a romantic getaway, a family vacation, or a company outing, sweeten it with a view to remember at the DoubleTree by Hilton, Port Huron.
Back here at McMoran Place, Will Wiggleman with you on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel and the ever-going debate about is Die Hard a Christmas movie was just brought up again here in the arena. Not sure what you fans think at home. You can discuss in the comments section. I'm willing to give it the Christmas movie distinction. But you guys can discuss in the comments section as you watch the last half of this third period. Prowlers need three goals in the next 9:37. to at least tie the game and get a point out of this weekend series with the FPHL's top team. Chartrand on the headman feed, drops it to Scantlebury. His shot, he scores! Well, that face-off play worked for the Prowlers. Tucker Scantlebury with a wicked wrister beats McBurney, and the Prowlers have some life. Alex Johnson brought the whole forward group to him to draw up that play. He sent it all the way up the ice to Chartrand, who dropped it off to Scantlebury as they entered the zone, and a great wrist shot from Tucker Scantlebury. Beats McBurney to the blocker's side. A big goal for the Prowlers. They just trail by two now, and they put some energy into this crowd that's made the trip through some cold temperatures, snow and wind tonight in Port Huron. Chartrand again. Chartrand picking up his first FPHL assist to go with his first goal that he had back in November against the Mississippi Seawolves. That was an empty net goal for Chartrand, but they all count the same on the score sheet. 8:42 to go, third period. Here's Rogers. His feed goes all the way to Noonan. He'll flip it back to center. Underwood regains control in his own end. Vanelli cut off by Freeborn. Jay couldn't enter the zone. Henning had a man bearing down on him, able to get it past him. Now Rogers back up. Krupp tried to deflect it in. Hainzel knocked it down. Here is Adam Hainzel. Dumps it in, goes after it himself. Vanelli worked it to the far side. Jay cut it off. Freeborn couldn't take control. Wickline works a rush the other way. Cody Wickline to the slot off of Noonan's mask. Prowlers looking for a counterattack. It's Graham to Freeborn. Back to Jay. Quick shot, save McBurney. And it bounces around. Rogers finally controls it when it drops onto the ice. Cody Rogers has it again. Up to Krupp. And now Matt Graham into the zone. But it's poked back to center. Freeborn sent it over to the far side. Graham first on it. And now Vanelli looks to start a rush. Rims it near side to King. And he goes back to center and into Prowler territory with 7:15 to go. Deflected in, LaBelle dropped it off to Vanelli. Around to King. Kelly had to turn for it. Here's Jacob Kelly. Feeds it down low. Williams and King come together. Sam Williams. Try to feed up just right to Kelly by accident. Looked like it hit a stick. And luckily for the Prowlers, Joe Noonan able to get a piece of that Jacob Kelly shot. Vartiainen poked off his stick at the line. Kelly back in. And he's stood up by Gino Mini with a nice hit. Devaney to Vartiainen. Right back to Joe Devaney with speed. Devaney took a whack, arm comes up, puck goes out of play. And now Greco and Devaney dropping the mitts. Looked like they were going to fight. And then Williams came in and tackled everybody, or that was Alex Johnson, excuse me, who came in and tackled everybody. Devaney still has one glove on. Greco's lost both mitts and his helmet. And now the penalties will come. Looked like the play ended innocently enough, and then Greco came right after Joe Devaney. Fist started flying, and both Greco and Devaney head to the penalty box. And it looks like they're directing Devaney to the locker room, I believe. Right now he's heading to the bench. now he'll take a seat on the bench. It looked like the referee was pointing to the locker room for Joe Devaney, but instead, he's hanging out on the Prowlers' bench. That's where the Prowlers would like him to stay, as much preferred than the dressing room. Joe Devaney, one of the top Prowlers. 6:12 to go in the third period as they figure all of this out. Prowlers looking for a bit of a spark. They may have gotten it from Joe Devaney. Of course, Tucker Scantlebury's goal injected some life in this crowd and in the team. Right now, 4 minutes are up on the clock on the Columbus River Dragons side. Dustin Henning returning to his bench to report what he's learned from the referees. Josh Petrantonio still over there for Columbus. River Dragons captain needing a little bit of an extra explanation. That 4 minutes is the only penalty up there. So the Prowlers currently 0-4 on the power play. If they get a 4 minute man advantage, that could be huge in making a comeback in this game, and that's what it looks like it will be. Just Michael Greco in the penalty box for 4 minutes. There are two separate penalties. It's a slash, which was the original call that the referee had his arm up for, and then a roughing penalty that came after the rough stuff, after the whistle, and it's part of that rough stuff. So the Prowlers on a 4 minute power play. Two minor penalties to Michael Greco. And the faceoff comes to Frejo in the corner. He rims it all the way around past Freeborn at the point and back to center. Here's Johnson dancing his way through center, gives it up to Graham. Lots of space, but he fed it across. Jay couldn't control it cleanly. Now Graham in front. Merritt backhand, it's bouncing. And McBurney able to gather it in. Thought Matt Graham had an opportunity to shoot that puck with plenty of space moving through the right wing circle, but instead he elected to pass it off and not in the wheelhouse of Dalton Jay. So the Prowlers don't get an opportunity off of that rush. They did get one towards the net. Sam Merritt unable to get a lot of that bouncing puck. Here's Johnson. Almost gave it away to Underwood, trying to make a pass. Graham couldn't force it in front. Now Jay looking to center. Gives to Freeborn. Over to Johnson. One-timer. Blocked in front. May have hit Matt Graham. Johnson again. Wrist shot. Kick save by McBurney. And Wickline able to chop it back to Prowler ice. 50 seconds into the Prowler power play. As they re-enter the zone. Freeborn looking, trying to find that puck. Now Sam Williams puts it down low. Here's Jay behind the net, centered. That got through everyone. Schumacher feeds it across to Jay. That pass too hot to handle, and it's chopped out of play. And Ozelish gives an extra shove to Dalton Jay. Jay right back to Ozelish. And oh man, I wonder what Dalton Jay had in his hand there. Edgar Zozelinch looks like he got shot as he fell down. We'll take a timeout here as the Prowlers fans give some cheers and jeers to Edgar Zozelinch's acting effort behind the net. 4:59 to go, third period. Prowlers on the power play. You're watching Port Huron Prowlers Hockey on the Prowlers YouTube channel.
I've worked at Pioneer and now Corteva for 36 years. It goes by very quickly.
This is a pretty noble profession for your giving back to humanity.
Curiosity is so important. I learn something new every day.
What's that next challenge that may occur for farmers?
You do really feel like you've got an impact on what's coming.
I can see how we're making things better.
And we have the best solutions for our farmers. Then I think we're here to feed and fuel the world. I'm proud to be part of that culture, and I'm proud to be part of the company.
invite you to tune into our next broadcast on Monday, December 26th, when the Prowlers visit the Elmira Mammoth. Puck drop is scheduled for 7:35 p.m. and the pregame show starts at 6:20. It's all right here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Michael Greco is being escorted from the penalty box to the locker room. Not sure why, but now Justin Schmidt will head in to serve the remaining 2 minutes and 46 seconds of Greco's penalty. I don't see an extra penalty up here on my monitor here, so not exactly sure why Michael Greco is heading to the locker room, but either way, Prowlers stay on the power play, but they'll have to chase. 38 seconds left on the first penalty. Then it will be another, of course, 2 minutes for the Prowlers. Here's Joe Devaney, who drew both calls. Devaney into the zone, taking off his stick. King on the second chance opportunity, now third whack, able to get it down. Schumacher quickly up to Sam Williams. Backhanded deep. Big hit behind the net, but the River Drag is able to get it back to center. They've killed off the first minor penalty. Here's Larry Vartiainen giving up to Schumacher. Greg Schumacher rims it around. Graham looking for it, but Storjahan lifted his stick and clears it back all the way down. Not the power play the Prowlers wanted, really, at this point in the game. This is a big opportunity. Let's see if they can at least get one on the man advantage. Scantlebury working with Vanelli down the boards. Comes to Graham. Down to Scantlebury. Head up. Finds Jay. Turned it on the cage. Storjahan just gets it past Scantlebury all the way down. We hit the final minute of the Prowlers power play. 3:14 to go in the third period. Johnson up ice. Rimmed around to the near side. Matt Graham up to Freeborn. Back to Graham. He turned it over to Kelly, and he gets it down to Prowler territory. Fans growing restless here. The Prowlers unable to really get much set up on this power play. Jay dropped it off to Williams. 30 seconds left on the man advantage for the Prowlers. And that goes off of Freeborn skate. And the Prowlers have to start all over again. Williams to Freeborn. Through center, gets around his man. Freeborn taken down. Penalty is coming. And the Prowlers will go back to the power play. 6 seconds left in the penalty to Greco being served by Justin Schmidt. So that will be a 5-on-3 for the Prowlers, an abbreviated 5-on-3. And then they'll be 5-on-4 for a minute 54 after that. Frageau heads to the box, arguing all the way. 2:18 to go, third period. Critical moments for the Prowlers. They'll need one quick. They'll try to get, as they try and get back into this game. Scantlebury, Williams, Vartiainen, Devaney, and Schumacher. The forwards for the power play for the Prowlers. LaBelle is out there for Columbus, along with Wickline, and it looks like Oselich. Scantlebury wins the faceoff. Schumacher couldn't get it over to Devaney, so that kills off one penalty. And now it's 5-on-4. Vartiainen with a quick shot, and McBurney hangs on. Joe Noonan heading to the bench. And now he'll retreat back to his goal crease with 2:07 to go third period. Minute 49 left on the Prowlers' man advantage. Keep an eye on Joe Noonan, who's out past the hash marks in his own end. Prowlers take control, so he heads to the bench. Extra attacker out for the Prowlers. It's Matt Graham. So a 6-on-4 advantage for Port Huron. They need two. Up to the top, Schumacher to Devaney, to the slot, Williams, and a save by McBurney. Sam Williams didn't get all he wanted on that shot. But McBurney sliding across makes a nice save. So Matt Graham will get set to draw with Josh Petrantonio. As the 6-on-4 commences. Work back to the point, Schumacher. Devaney back to Schumacher, the one-timer. Save, rebound pops out, and it's cleared to the corner. Scantlebury up to Devaney. Puts it on, blocked in front, sent all the way down, wide of the empty net. Schumacher chasing after it, so is Petrantonio. Josh Petrantonio works it in front to Doe, who scores. Prowlers up 6-on-4. Schumacher slams his stick in frustration. We're outnumbered by the River Dragons in their own zone. And again, a 6-on-4 advantage. And Austin Doe hits the empty net to pretty much seal this one up as the River Dragons come in and they sweep the Port Huron Prowlers, unless something drastic happens in the next minute and 20 seconds. A frustrating night for Port Huron. Out shooting Columbus 34-28 right now, but unfortunately for the Prowlers, couldn't beat Bailey McBurney. All too many times they've had a few posts, a few opportunities that just didn't go their way. And unfortunately for the Prowlers, it looks like they will head into the Christmas break empty-handed, but they won't have all too long to think about it as they're offsides here at the line. They won't have all that long to think about it as they're back in action on Monday, Boxing Day, the 26th, and that's a road game in Elmira, the first game for the Port Huron Prowlers against the Elmira Mammoth. Graham looking for Jay. Vannelli cut it off, got it back to center. Freeborn, his pass across, hit Storjahan on his way through. Jay down low to Merritt. Comes all the way out. Freeborn. Shot kick save by McBurney. Chopped out to center. Back to 5-on-5. 18 seconds left. Third period. Johnson through center. Into the Dragon zone. Takes the shot. McBurney shoulders it off. And he goes out of play with 8.9 seconds up on the clock in this third period. So the Prowlers dropped to 1-5 against the River Dragons this season. 11-9-3 overall, 35 points. That's still good for third in the Continental Division. But it looks like the Carolina Thunderbirds will sneak back up on them and get within a couple of points. Unless the 9-player Mississippi Seawolves can make a big comeback tonight. As the final buzzer sounds, the Port Huron Prowlers fall to the Columbus River Dragons by a score of 5-2 tonight from McMoran Place. Before we get too deep into the post-game show, another reminder to tune into our next broadcast on Monday, December 26th, when the Prowlers are in Elmira. Puck drop is at 7:35, and the pregame show starts at 7:15 right here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel. Well, this was a good start for the Prowlers in tonight's game. And it was Dalton Jay getting the first goal of the game just over 5 minutes in, putting home his own rebound on a breakaway. But from there, it was mostly River Dragons. Cody Rogers answered just a few minutes after Jay got the lead for the Prowlers. Alexander Jemeff got another goal shorthanded for Columbus. And it was 2-1 River Dragons before the end of the opening period. Jacob Kelly scored the only goal of the middle frame. And then Kelly scored again early in the third. He's a man who's terrorized the Prowlers in his games this season. He's turning into a bright young star for these Columbus River Dragons. Tucker Scantleberry brought the Prowlers back within two with under 10 minutes to play, but unfortunately for Port Huron, that's as close as they would get. Austin Doe hit the empty netter. That was the second shorthanded goal for Columbus tonight. And that's how it ends for the Port Huron Prowlers. So unfortunately, again for Port Huron, they go home, they go into the Christmas break getting no points in a two-game series here at McMorran Place. They fall to 4-6-1 at home this season. So not exactly defending home ice as well as they would have wanted, as well as they really want to. It's the first time the Prowlers have been swept this season since November 18th and 19th when they were in Columbus against these River Dragons, who continue to sit atop the FPHL and lord over the rest of the Federal Prospects Hockey League teams, now up to 53 points at 18-2-1. 10-2 now on the road are the Columbus River Dragons. So a tough night for the Port Huron Prowlers. Let's give you one quick look around the FPHL. The Carolina Thunderbirds are up still on the Mississippi Seawolves. It's now 5-1 Carolina. And then in Danbury, it's the Hattricks up on the Delaware Thunder in the late in the second. 4-2 the score in Danbury, Connecticut. Jacob Kelly with another multi-point night against the Prowlers. Plenty of River Dragons getting on the score sheet. Only five River Dragons without a point tonight in this game. They only did score five goals, so very spread out scoring. Jacob Kelly and Lane King, the only River Dragons with multiple points. Kelly had two goals, King with two assists. Bailey McBurney picks up the victory, 33 saves on 35 shots tonight for Columbus. And for McBurney, it's another victory in a long string of them. Number 10 on the year. For the Prowlers, nobody with a multi-point effort tonight. Tucker Scantleberry and Dalton Jay with the goals. Dan Chartrand and Alex Johnson picking up an assist apiece. That's it on the score sheet for the Prowlers in terms of goals and assists. Joe Noonan made 24 saves on 28 shots. He drops his first game of the 2022-23 season. Well, that's going to do it for me. Have a Merry Christmas weekend, Prowlers fans. We will see you back here on the Port Huron Prowlers YouTube channel on Boxing Day. But for now, again, have a safe and healthy Christmas weekend. We'll see you on Monday.